Today we will study operation of three-phase inverter with R-load in MATLAB Simulink. So before moving to the Simulink model, first we will see the diagram of a three-phase load. So a three-phase inverter. So we can see here, this is basically the circuit diagram for the three-phase inverter circuit, where we can see we have applied one DC voltage source. Six switches are there, that is S1, S2, S3, S4, S5 and S6. Six switches are there, and we have connected three phase load. We are here in this circuit, we have connected three phase star connected load, and they are 120 degree displaced from each other, the phases. So N is the neutral point. We will be getting VAN, VBN and VCN. This will be the neutral voltages, and line voltages will be VAB, VBC, VCA respectively. Now, before setting up the Simulink model for this three-phase inverter, we have to remember few conditions, that each switch conducts for a period of 120 degree or half 180 degree or half electrical cycle. This is the first point. Second one is, one complete cycle is divided into six modes. That means one complete cycle is up to 0 to 360 degree, and this complete cycle is divided into six modes. Each mode is of a interval of 60 degree. The triggering sequence for the switches will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in this way. The name S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. The triggering sequence is in this way only. Phase shift between triggering the two adjacent switches is 60 degree. In every step of 60 degree duration, only three switches are conducting, two from the upper group and one from the lower group. So basically these things we will have to keep in mind before setting up the Simulink model. Now we will move to the MATLAB model of this three-phase inverter. So, to open MATLAB model, we have to open Simulink library first. From Simulink library, we will be moving to blank model. Here, first we will make the circuit diagram for the three-phase inverter. Now, open Simulink library. So, if we move to the circuit diagram, we can see here, first requirement is one DC voltage source. Next requirement is six switches. We will use six IGBT switches, and star connected load. This is the basic requirement. So, what we will do is, we will take DC voltage source, then we will be taking IGBT switches. So we will take IGBT diode. Next requirement is star connected load. So for that, series RLC branch is required. Next requirement is power GUI block. So first to give gate pulses, we will have to give pulse generator. Okay, so this first we require this thing, so we will make circuit first. So we are having DC voltage source. IGBT diode is there. Press Ctrl R to rotate this. Double click on this IGBT diode off measurement port. We require 6 switches. Power GUI block we will place here. 6 switches are required. So 2 3 4 6 switches are there. So the connection will be like this. As we can see in our circuit diagram, the connection will be like this. This is A phase, this one is B phase, this one is C phase, and the star connected load will get connected like this. So now we need 6 pulse generator for all the switches, all 6 switches. So six pulse generator is required. So 6 pulse generator is required, and we will connect star connected load to the system. So take it here, double click on this series RLC branch, select branch type, click on R. So we have to make star connected load. So this one is Control C. So Control R. Star connected load means this 3 points will be connected in with the neutral point. So we will be taking ground. We will be taking ground. So this is the neutral point. A star connected load. So this is your phase A, phase B, phase C. Now we will rename the switches. This one will be UDC. This one will be termed as switch 1. Switch 1. Switch 4. Switch 4. This one is switch 3. Switch 6. Switch 5. Switch 2. So these are the names of the switches. So this is the load for this is phase A. This is B. This one is C. Now we will have to measure line voltages and phase voltages, and we will have to check all the get pulses that we are providing. Okay, the all get pulses will get 60 degree shifted from each other. So first we will be moving to the VDC. So this input voltage we will be giving as 540 volt. VDC we will set as 540 volts. Then we will move to pulse generator. Pulse generator for switch 1. Now pulse generator for switch 1, your amplitude you can give 1 to 5, anything 1 or 5. Time period is given. Time period is given in seconds. So we know that frequency, standard Indian frequency is 50 Hertz. So time period will be 1 by 50, that is 0.02. Pulse width. Now we have to check what is the pulse width for this switch. So to describe this, I will be moving here. So here you can see, if we take one sinusoidal waveform, say we will consider one sine wave here, say the entire cycle is from 0 to 360 degree. So this entire cycle is from 0 to 360 degree. So if I consider conduction period of one switch is 180 degree, as we know from our condition that conduction period for each switch will be 180 degree, and 360 degree is the complete cycle. 0 to 360 degree will be the complete cycle. So if we consider 360 degree as 100%, if we consider 360 degree as 100% conduction period, then for 180 degree, conduction period will be what? For 180 degree, it will be, the conduction period for the switch will be 100 for 180 degree. For 180 degree, conduction period of the switch will be 100 divided by 180 100 divided by 360 into 180. So if we consider 360 degree as 100% conduction cycle, then for 180 degree, what will be the width of the pulse? That is 100 by 360 into 180. So finally, this we can say as 50%. this we can say as 50%. So in place of width of the pulse, we will give in place of width of the pulse we will give In place of width of the pulse, we will give 50% of the period, time period 0.0 to 1 by 50, amplitude I am keeping 1. Phase delay is 0 for this first switch. Name apply and then OK. Now we will be moving to the second pulse, that is pulse generator for the switch 3. Now if we consider this one, we have considered switch 1, switch 4. This one is for phase A, switch 3, switch 6 for phase B, and this is for phase C. Now phase A, phase B, phase C will be 120 degree displaced from each other. The difference between two phases is 120 degree. That means if we consider phase difference between two phase 120 degree, that means if we consider three phases, say one phase we have considered that R is equal to sine theta, another say we have considered that means B phase will become sine theta plus 120 degree, and next another phase will be sine theta plus 240 degree. So these are the three phases. Three phases will be 120 degree displaced from each other. So if we are triggering phase A at zero phase delay, that means we will trigger next phase after 120 degree, because phase difference between two phases in electrical system is 120 degree. As phase difference is 120 degree, that means if we are triggering phase A at zero phase delay, then we will trigger phase B at zero plus 120 degree, 120 degree phase shifted, so it will be 120 degree. So we will have to consider that. Now you can see in your MATLAB that phase delay is given in second, so you have to convert it into second. So if we consider total sequence is up to, total cycle is up to 360 degree, that means and total time period is 0.02 second, that means for 360 degree your phase delay will be 0.02 second. So if for 360 degree it is 0.02 second, then for 120 degree, then for 120 degree what it will become, 0.02 by 360 into 120. This will be the value of phase delay for switch 3. Now again we will move to our MATLAB circuit and we will put this value here. So rest of the things will same. So amplitude will be 1, time period will be 0.02, this is the total one. Pulse width will be 50%, because each switch is conduct for the half electrical cycle, that is 180 degree. Phase delay, now it is 120 divided by 360 into 0.02. So this will be the phase delay for switch 3. Apply and OK. Next we will move to switch 5, that is pulse generator for switch 5. Now here phase C is another 120 degree shifted, that means 120 plus 120, that is 240 degree now. So In this case, your pulse generator will become, the phase delay will become 240 divided by 360 into 0.02. Pulse width will be 50% same. It is 0.02. Amplitude is 1. So this is for switch 5. Now we will move to pulse generator 3, that is pulse generator for switch 4. Now as per our condition, phase difference between upper switch and lower switch will be 180 degree. That means lower switch will be 180 degree out of phase with the upper switch. So in using this condition, we have to give the phase delays for the pulse generator. So what will be there? Same thing, 180 degree shifted from switch 1. So pulse generator for switch 4 will become, so for switch 1, you can see for switch 1 phase delay is 0. So for switch 4 phase delay will be 180 degree. So 0 plus 180 degree out of phase, so it is 180 degree. So this is amplitude, time period will be 0.02 same, 50% pulse width. Phase delay will be what? Phase delay will be 180 divided by 360 into 0.02. Next, pulse generator for switch 6. Again, lower layer is 180 degree out of phase with the upper layer. So we can see for switch 3, this phase delay is 120 degree. So for switch 6, it will become 180 plus 120, because switch 6 is 180 degree out of phase with switch 3. So it will become 180 plus 120, that is 300. So remaining things will be same. Pulse width will be 50%. Phase delay we will give 300, that is 180 plus 120 by 360 into 0.02. Next we will be moving to switch 2, pulse generator for switch 2. Now again, switch 2 is 180 degree out of phase with switch 5. So in switch 5, 240 degree is the phase delay for switch 5. So 240 plus 120 plus 180, that will be the that will be the phase delay for switch 2. So that is nothing but 60 degree, for that is coming 420 degree, and 420 is equivalent to the 60 degree. That means 180 minus 120, it is 60 degree. So we can write here 60, or you can write 420 by 360. That is also, you can write 60 by 360 into 0.02, and this will remain same. Period will be 0.02, pulse width will be 50%. So all the pulse generators we have given. Now we will have to check voltages, line voltages and phase voltages, and we have to check the gate current. So for that we have to check measurement blocks. So individually I will show you. First we will see all the gate pulses according to the conditions or not. So first we will take scope. So here first we will see all the gate pulses, they are 60 degree shifted or not. As you know that the total cycle is up to 360 degree, and this 0 to 360 degree is divided into 6 mode, each shifted by 60 degree with each other. So 6 pulse generator we have to check. So click on setting, number of input ports make 6, layout I have selected this way, 3 3. So apply and okay. So as for the sequence, we will arrange it. Means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In this sequence, I will be connecting this get pulses with the spoke. So first we will connect switch 1. First I am connecting switch 1. I will give name here. So this is S1. Next I will be connecting switch 2, that is here. So I am giving name here switch 2. So name is given switch 2. Next I will be connecting switch 3. Next switch 4. Next switch 5. And finally switch 6. So I will run this one. So first I will check all the pulses are working properly or not. So first I will run this circuit using only I am using this code. Now next phase we will be checking all line voltages and all phase voltages, and we will be checking RMS values are coming same or not, that it is satisfying your theoretical equation or not. So checking this. So if you check this gate pulses, this is for switch 1, this is for switch 2, you can see this is the waveform for switch 1. Then this is for switch 2. The phase difference between this is 60 degree. You can see here 60 degree phase shifted, switch 2 get pulse. Next another 60 degree phase shifted, switch 3. Next we are having switch 4. Switch 5 is another 60 degree, and then we are finally having switch 6. So all the pulses will be 60 degree phase shifted, and all the conditions are satisfying. And here you can see S1, S4 is there. S1, S2, S3. These three are the upper switches. So you can see here, they are, S1, S4 is the switches in one arm, one leg. You can see S1 and S4. So what is the condition here? The condition is, in one arm you can see S1 and S4. So you can see S1 and S4, the S4 will be 180 degree out of phase with S1. So if we check the graph, if you check this S1 and S4, you can see when S1 is on, your S4 is off. That means S1 and S4 will be 180 degree out of phase with each other. Same for S2 and S5, you can see, and same goes for S3 and S6, you can see. So your conditions are satisfied for the gate pulses, and they are, and pulses for adjacent switches are 60 degree shifted from each other. That is also you can see from this graph. Now we will be checking line voltages and phase voltages. So for that we require a voltage measurement block. voltage measurement block will require, and we will again we will check RMS values that is coming as per your theoretical equation or not. That is also we will check. So for that we will check one RMS block. One RMS block, and to see the value, RMS value, we will take display. So, we will be connecting this ladder. First, we will check all the line voltages and phase voltages. Line voltages means VAB, VBC and VCA. These are the line voltages, and phase voltages, the voltages with respect to the neutral point. That means VAN, VBN and VCN. So first we will connect phase voltages. For that we require a 3 voltage measurement block. So each will be connected. We will be checking phase voltage first. So this will be connected with respect to the neutral point. Same for this one, VBN. VCN. We will be taking one scope. Now we require 3 inputs. So we will be giving number of input port 6. Layout we will fix like this. Okay. And we will be connecting. First we will connect with VA. Then VB, then VC. We'll give name. This is for A, this is for B, and this one is for C. So first we will check this phase voltages. So here we this one is for the gate pulses. We will write here gate pulse. This one is for the phase voltages. So now we will again run the circuit. Go here. If we go here, you can see. So you can see 60 degree phase shifted pulses there all, and finally we are getting quasi square wave with a peak value of EDC, that is the we are getting the EDC value, the peak value of EDC, and 3 line voltages are mutually phase shifted by 120 degree. So we can see this waveform from this one. So you can see phase A, phase B, phase C voltages from this graph. So now we will check RMS values for this graph. Now to check that, we have to connect RMS points here. One second. So from here we can check the RMS values. Now if we double click on this RMS plot, then we can see here your fundamental frequency is given. We will set it as 50 hertz. Initial RMS value is 0, sample time is 0. Now here you can see one point, that is true RMS value. Now true RMS value, if we check this one, it will check all the components for calculation of RMS voltage. But if we will not select this one, it will check only the fundamental component for calculation of the RMS voltage. So we will see the fundamental one also. So for the first one, we will check the fundamental one. So we will not select this true RMS value for the first block, and rest of the block RMS values are there. Here we will check true RMS value. That means it will check all the components for the calculation. We will make fundamental frequency 50 hertz. We will make initial RMS value 0. Same goes for the third RMS portion also. We will make 50 hertz frequency. Initial RMS value we will make 0. Sample time will be 0. Now again we will run the circuit. We are done. Now you can check here. Already we have checked phase voltages. We have checked this one. Next you can see all the RMS values. So this one here we have taken only the fundamental one. So this is the fundamental RMS value. So here fundamental RMS value we are getting 242.3. Now if we move to the theory part, you can see RMS value of fundamental voltage, that is coming 0.7797 UTC. RMS value of phase voltage, this is 0.4714 UDC. RMS value of line voltage, that is 0.8165 UDC. So this is basically, so if you calculate this one, it will be coming like this only. If you calculate this one, that means you have applied 540 volt here in VDC. So this one, this 254 will be coming, 254 will be coming from here, 0.4714 into UDC. This one will be 0.4714 into 540. If you do that, you will get this value 254, and corresponding 243 value also you are getting from the equation. So we are getting these fundamental values. Now we will remove this one. We will remove this one and we will check all the line voltages now. Now we will check all the line voltages. So we will delete this connection. Line voltages means VAB, VBC, VCA. That means A and the negative portion will go with this B. VAB, next VBC, that means this will go here, VBC, and next we are having VCA. This one. So VAB, VAB. Next we are having the BC, VBC, and next we are having the C. So this three line voltages we are having, we will check first. Line voltages again we will put, then we will see this. So line voltages are coming like this. I'll check it. line voltages are coming like this, the same way. And if we will, if you want to see the RMS values, then we will click on display and we will check RMS value. Same first fundamental one we will check, this is 50 and this one is 0. So it will give you display. For this one, this two we will be taking the entire value, that means true RMS value we will be taking. Now we will click on this run option. And you can check the value. This is the values for the line voltages are coming. So we can check this one. This is these are connected across the neutral point. Connect this one. 1 second. So this one. So finally, we are getting the values. So our final circuit will be like this. Our final circuit will be like this. Our line voltages and phase voltages we are getting. So our final circuit will be like this. And so all line voltages and phase voltages we are getting from here. So this is the phase voltage we are getting. You can get the fundamental components. Now to see the this is basically. So this is the final circuit we are getting. So finally we will check again all the graphs that are coming. So we can check here. So you can see here the fundamental values and the true values, RMS values are coming as per the equations. Same goes for the this is the phase voltage connection and line voltage connection means VAB, VBC and VCA. Same goes for the line voltage connection. If we check the circuit for the line voltage, you can find the same thing, that fundamental frequency is coming like this. So and the waveform for this we are getting here. This one is for the phase voltage. This one is for the line voltage. This one is for the line voltage we are getting. And this one we are getting for all the pulses. This one we are getting for all the pulses. 60 degree phase shifted pulses. So this is finally this is the final circuit for three phase inverter. Now here I have shown you only the phase voltages. Line voltage connection you can see from this circuit. Line voltage connection you can see from this circuit. The part is coming. Or I can show you line voltage connection also. So I can show you line voltage connection also. So line voltage connection means AB, BC, CA will be connected. So what is there is VAB, VBC is there. VCA is there. So first we will be taking AB. First we will be taking AB. Next we will be taking BC. And for this we will be taking this is AB. This one is coming BC. BC. And this one is coming CA. So this is the line voltage connection. So if we run this one, you can check this. So this is the waveform for the line voltages. And the final circuit you can check from here. Here the entire circuit is there. So entire circuit you can check from here. So this is the entire circuit, and if you go through the theory part, you can see we have applied 540 volt DC voltage. So as per our equation, all the RMS values are coming here. So you will perform this experiment and you will prepare the soft copy of the lab manual, and finally you will submit it. Thank you.